Kenyatta's coalition, Raila Odinga's coalition, ought to really come together to say, is it really credible to think that elections, credible elections, can take place in Kenya on the 26th of October? Personally, I don't think so. And there ought to be something to be done. The AU has a responsibility. The East African community has a responsibility. The UN has a responsibility to make sure that Kenya remains stable, peaceful, and properly governed. That Kenya doesn't go into crisis. And if all this is not done, Kenya will be in turmoil. Do we want Kenya to split? And it's not going to split into two. In my view, it may split into many parts. And that will be the end of Kenya. It will be the western part, the Rift Valley and Central Province, which used to be Central Province, the eastern part and northern part of the country, and then the coastal region. So Kenya is not very stable, and you need leadership elected that people can trust and indicate that they will accept what is happening. What does that require, in my view? It requires educating the public, the voters, about the responsibility they hold when they go to the election of the president. Do they want to split Kenya into pieces, or do they want one Kenya and build it up? And so it's a responsibility of the citizens of Kenya and the leaders. It has fundamental implications as we go forward. At the same time, I think that the current or the previous electoral management body that was not able to carry out its work properly with diligence is part of the problem and should be removed before elections are held. That means going back to the court to extend the period so that Kenya has enough time for the new electoral commissioners to come in to be properly adequate to deal with proper elections. Kenyans need to sit back and to say we want free, fair, credible elections which have integrity. And in order to do so, even if it means we delay the time, let's go to the court to extend the period.